Let's see if I could do something here. Is he gonna hit? Yeah, and they're suppressed too. Ooh, fantastic. That is really, really cool. Hello and welcome to Empire of Sin. If you'd like to check out the game, there is a link in the description. And do bear in mind that I do get a small percentage of the sale. So if you want to help me out and support the channel, then you can, of course, buy it through that link. Otherwise, it comes out today, and I'd highly recommend checking it out. This is absolutely fantastic. So far, I am having a whale of a time, and we're going to be playing a new game. Now, generally, you can play as anyone you want. There's actually a huge amount of different options with boss types. So these all have different boss abilities. Obviously, it's going to determine what kind of strategy you're going to use in the game itself. If you don't know anything about Empire of Sin, this is a turn-based, action point-based strategy game, and you are generally going to be attempting to run the best, most notorious gang that you can in 1920s Chicago. So you can obviously decide on who you want to lead that gang. So we have this guy right here. He is Irish-American, I believe. And as you can see, his boss ability is to use his bat. And he also has a number of empire bonuses as well. You can see exactly what those are doing. And then you also have a diplomacy bonus as well. So if you want to be a little bit more peaceful, then you can, of course, do that as well. Now, you have a number of other people here too. And you have a number of different abilities, as you see here. There's a lot of different choices. I'm just going to scroll through them just so that you can actually see. You even have Capone right here, which I think is amazing. I think it's really cool to see him in the game. And yeah, you basically have pretty much any kind of leader that you want. And they all have amazing different abilities. And it is just crazy. It is absolutely crazy how many options they've given you. And I'm going to be playing as Capone, because I feel like that makes the most sense. At least to me, because I get to make a lot of, you know, somewhat wise guy jokes. But we'll see. We'll see if that is indeed the case. Anyway, as you can see, his empire bonuses are allowing him to have a minus 20% to brewery production cost, as well as the brothel ambience cost being reduced by 20%. And his diplomacy bonus is a passive faction rating gain when in a defensive pact of plus one. That's pretty cool. So your allies become even more loyal to you. I suppose there's not really such a thing as loyalty at this time, but you know, we'll see what happens. Alright, so we have a number of customization options here. So obviously you have the difficulty. It ranks from associate, maid, lieutenant, underboss, and boss. We are most likely going to be just playing as lieutenant, because that is indeed the normal difficulty. And otherwise, we have neighborhoods. Alright, so basically neighborhoods determine how large the game world is and how long the game that you're going to play is going to be. So the maximum that you can currently do is 10, I think. Yeah, the maximum that you can do is 10. However, what you can do is you can reduce it to 3 if you want to have a really short game. But I'm going to just increase it to 10 for the moment. And you can also change the amount of enemy factions that you have as well. So if you want a really short game, you can go for 3 neighborhoods and you can go for 6 enemy factions. You can indeed make it very hectic and chaotic indeed by increasing the enemy factions that you have. But I'm going to just go for the standard default setup right here, and we'll continue. March 17th, 1920. Al Capone arrives in Chicago. He left New York to make a name for himself, a name no one would forget.
Evening, sir.
Ooh, yeah, okay, so this is actually randomized by the looks of things, or it could be from a potential of different options. So this is the tutorial. Basically, these two options right here, they will pretty much just say, do you want to do the tutorial, or do you not want to do the tutorial? I've already done the tutorial, so I'm actually not going to be doing it, and we're just going to say, just take me straight there.
Just take me straight there.
Sal drops Alphonse off on the street. Before long, every house on this street will know the name Capone. Alright, so here we go. this is where we are, and technically what we could do is, as you can see right here, we can skip the tutorial if we want, or we don't have to technically do that. I'm actually wondering whether I should just show you the tutorial, because it's actually very good. It does give you a very good overview of what to do and how to get there, and so on and so forth. Maybe we want to do it, maybe we don't. I'm actually going to skip it. I'm going to skip it. I've been around a block or two, so I've left some tips for you in the mission journal. All right, so here we go. All right. So basically how it goes is you can zoom out, okay? So the first thing you probably want to do, or at least what I want to do, is I want to show you exactly how large this game even is. Just look at the insanity right here. So all of these are different little areas of Chicago, and you're going to be able to go to each of these and expand your gang in whatever way you see fit. And there are a number of different menus as well that can help you to do that, and you can of course zoom in to the neighborhood menu as well if you want. This is the sort of world map overview of that, but if you want to zoom in and actually see what's going on here, then you can of course do that too. Oh yes, the game is actually running right now, so I should probably pause it a little bit. All right, so you have gangsters right here. Obviously you have Mr. Capone. He's obviously just relaxing. He's got a whole bunch of different traits, as you can see. So he has a number of different things that will affect how other people see him and how he's going to change how he operates, I suppose you could say. And then of course you have the black book. From here you can see which gangsters are available for hire, their relationships, their profession, and how much notoriety you need in order to hire them. And you'll notice that some gangsters are grayed out. That's because they won't work for just anybody. You've got to gain notoriety. Yes.
And you'll be well on your way to increasing notoriety and getting bigger and better gangsters. Select a gangster to learn more about them.
Alright, so we only have four options at the bottom here because we don't have enough notoriety just yet to be able to afford the others. As you can see right here, this is our notoriety bonus right here. We actually have 1,000 as our maximum cap, and at the moment we have 0. So we can basically get Grover Monks, Hugh Tank Miller, Gibby Willard, and Maria Rodriguez. And as you can see, they have a number of upfront costs as well. And they also take a 2% of the total profit. So I'm actually unsure who to take here right now. But we have to be a bit careful, because if we take, for example, Gibby Willard, you'll see that they're not really a big fan of Hugh Tank Miller, so you can see that they kind of hate each other, so it's probably not a good idea to take those together. So I'm thinking what we'll probably do is we'll probably take Gibby.
Hey. There are three key things you've got to know about every gangster. The first thing is loyalty. Loyalty is a measure of their time with you. The longer they're with you, the higher their loyalty goes. The higher their loyalty, the lower their cost, and the less likely they are to flip if the cops get to them. The second thing is morale. Morale is a measure of how satisfied they are. Morale goes up and down depending on how things are going. When an enemy gets clipped, morale is going to go up. The more satisfied a gangster is, the better they perform. The third thing is traits. Traits are reflective of a gangster's experience before they met you, but they evolve through gameplay too. Traits affect all kinds of things, from their actions to their interactions with others. Some even affect your entire empire.
Exactly, that's what I was talking about earlier with Mr. Capone having all of these different traits and being able to gain more of them as time goes on.
There's plenty to learn on the gangster's rap sheet, so explore different areas to get more information.
Yeah, so if we want to hire Mr. Gibby right here, I suppose we will be doing that. Let us hire him. There we go.
Hey, what's going on? How can I help?
Would you like to choose a talent? Ooh, yes, okay, sure. I would like to definitely choose a talent. Okay, so we can either select shrapnel bomb or break shot. Take aim at the target's weapon. A successful hit will break the target's weapon. Or shrapnel bomb. Throw a shrapnel bomb at the target area. All targets in the blast are hit with bleed, slow, and knockback. That sounds really fun, actually. Considering this fellow is a demolitionist, it kind of makes sense for us to take that. And it's going to take 18 days for him to learn this, which is absolutely fine. I have no problem with that whatsoever. So let's go back to the gang screen right here. and let us hire someone else. Alright, so I'm not going to be hiring this guy because obviously he and the demolitionist that we just hired do not get along at all. So it makes no sense. And I'm just going to take a look at these other two just to see what's going on with them. Oh, this guy's got a rifle. Ooh, yeah, that seems pretty cool. Effective range being long sounds like a lot of fun to me. So, might make sense. Might make sense. And what is the relationship like here? Minerva Lee is an enemy. Oh, no, wait. Oh, no, in love. Oh, my bad. Well, in some cases, you never know. But yes, that is actually a heart there. I actually thought that was a, you know, aggressive symbol of some kind. But no. Okay. All right. So that, yeah, let's hire Mr. Right, Grover Monks. Would you like to choose a talent for him? Yes, I would. Place a mark on the target. Mark targets have their defense reduced by 25%, lasts for 3 rounds. Or sweep, fire a stream of bullets over the target area with a chance to deal damage to any target caught in the area of effect. Not a big fan of the sweep thing. I'm going to take mark target because that lasts three turns. Could be really useful for just basically murdering one guy really, really fast. So I think that's really cool. Also, you can rename all of your characters too, which I think is really quite amazing. So if you take a look here, I can't rename Capone, of course. But if you take a look here, I can rename this guy to whatever I want. So we could just go, you know what? Let's just have a hilarious time. Willard. There we go. That is his name now. Oh, yes. That is his name. And, you know what? I'm gonna do this. This is a San Andreas? San Andreas reference? Grove Street. There we go. Isn't it? I think so. Okay, well, anyway, that seems pretty good to me. And there we go. Okay, so we're done with that. Okay, so our mission screen basically is just giving us a very brief overview of what we should probably end up doing. If there's one thing Chicago ain't short on, it's rackets. Every two-bit gangster in this town wants to make their mark. Cut them down to size by taking their rackets. Go get 5 rackets now and play some tennis. Ah, no, it's not that kind of racket, of course. Okay. Yeah, Frankie Yale, confront the thugs. Okay, yeah, so we're going to be doing brick by brick at least a little bit. And we also have our black market here. So basically, every single time you want to buy something, you can go into this menu and you can buy some stuff. I'm actually going to be buying 2 first aid kits because I personally feel like having some first aid could be quite important. And otherwise, let's zoom out, shall we? All right. So I'm going to select my gang, because I can actually do that. I can turn them into a little fighting force, I guess you could call it. And otherwise, I think it's probably a good idea that we try to take over one of these buildings. So, for example, this one over here. So, wait a minute. Let me actually just, I'm just going to move to that one and just see what happens. Because we might get ambushed. There is a possibility that we will indeed get ambushed. Let's actually unpause the game for the moment. All right, so there you go. There's Al. He's moving. Head into the gangster's rap sheet to learn to. I'll skip it. Thank you. I know how to equip those things. Thank you very much. But basically, you can go here, and this is his inventory screen, and you can pretty much just go and click this, and then you can equip whatever you want. I think, Willard is going to be using the grenades, which is nice. But they all have a first aid kit equipped, which is going to be very important. So pretty happy with that. And as time goes on, by the way, you're also going to be gaining additional cash. As you can see right now, unfortunately, due to the crew that I currently have, I'm currently losing $600 per week. But I will be able to gain more as we take over more and more territory. So let's get into the action, shall we? Because I think that is about time. Do I want to know how combat works? No, I already know how that works. Thank you very much. I can explain it to you easily enough as well. It's very straightforward. It does require a little bit of strategic thinking. Quite a lot of strategic thinking, but hopefully I'll be able to do okay with it. Anyway, fire hail of bullets. This is actually really cool as well. This is a fantastic ability. So let's see if I can... Let's see if I can do something here. Is he gonna hit? Yeah! And they're suppressed too! Ooh, fantastic. That is really, really cool. Can I select Willard right now? No, unfortunately not. Yeah, basically determining who goes first is to do with your initiative rank. So the higher your initiative, the faster that particular character is going to be able to act. So let's see what we can do here. Okay, so we have the ability to potentially kill that thug on the left. Let's try and kill the thug on the left, shall we? Oh, took him down, took him down. That's nice. Alright, so Willard now has the ability to go, and I'm thinking we might want to use shrapnel bomb. We might just want to use shrapnel bomb almost immediately right here. Where is that, by the way? Where is that? Where's this? Oh, no, he doesn't have that yet. Oh, yes, I forgot. He needs to train it up a little bit. Okay, so I guess we'll just use a grenade. I mean, I do have to buy the grenades. That's the only problem, you see. Oh, he's got a 38% chance. He's got a Thompson. So it might very well be. Every single hit, by the way, is calculated separately. So 38% chance, it might very well be that he will at least hit once. So let's try it. Nice. He actually did hit once. Very good. Very good. Oh, that guy's using a first aid kit. Are you serious? That is not very good. Oh, well, it's good for him, I suppose. Oh, this guy literally walked into the area and then got hit. And now they're getting suppressed as well. Capone is an absolute beast. Wow. I can't believe it. I can't believe that that actually worked so incredibly effectively. Okay, let's hit this guy. Take him out. There you go. Every single time, by the way, that Capone gets a kill, he gains notoriety. And notoriety, of course, is going to help him to be able to recruit more and more powerful lieutenants. So that's what we will try to do as much as we possibly can. Alright, so let's see. 62% chance. We might. Oh, nice hit. Wow, what a beast that guy is. Okay, crazy. Alright, so I'm thinking we'll probably just try for the 38. Nice. Two hits. Very good indeed. This guy's going for a melee attack? He's trying to hit Capone in the face. He's got a personal grudge against Mr. Capone here. That is not very nice of you at all. Ah, goodbye. There we go. And that's it. That is generally how combat will go. Obviously, we got very lucky there with all of them running into our suppression area. And also, we do get some loot here. You can see that it has a wide variety of different bonuses. And you can indeed sell these things as well. So if you want a little bit of extra cash, you can sell that. Or if you want to, you know, get a couple of you get a couple of extra lieutenants and maybe they don't have a very good weapon, then you can, of course, do that as well. So you have a number of different options when you take over a racket. So you can take it over, which means that you gain control of the building. You can ransack it, which means you raid the building, you walk away with some money. You can destroy the building, which will, well, as you can see right here, temporarily disable it. This action will close the building for a long period of time. Or you can raise the building because we have a demolitionist. This will remove the building from not only your control, but every other faction. But I think it's pretty easy to see what we want to do, because obviously the first mission we have is to hold 5 rackets, and we get nothing for these other options. Ransack is okay, of course, but I would much rather have the passive income from taking over the business itself. So that is exactly what we're going to do. So when you click on Takeover, you have the option to change what this actually does. If you were to take over something that already does something, so for example, if you were to attack a rival gang's brewery, for example, then you would be able to take over that brewery, specifically just that brewery, for free. And you wouldn't need to spend any money to be able to build an additional building. So if you understand what I mean, it would basically just be you moving in and taking over that particular business. However, because this is a vacant building, I'm going to have to spend money to be able to do this. So let's have a look here. Okay, it seems like the speakeasy is the way to go because we earn more cash from that, and the upkeep is just the same as the brothel. So I think that that is seemingly a much better idea. So we're going to do that. And we can indeed name it. So I'm going to name it Not Capone's Place. There we go, because that's not suspicious at all. Yes, that is not suspicious whatsoever. Alright, so you picked up a new tier of weapon. Head into the... I'll skip it, actually. Thank you very much. A new tier of weapon? Really? I don't think so, somehow. This thing? Really? Is it much better than what I was using? Oh, yeah, it's green. Of course, it's green. So obviously that means that it's a little bit better than the other things. Potentially, maybe for Willard. Might be something good for him. Let's actually take a look. Is it actually better than what he's using? 13 to 24. It is actually better than what he's using. I'm surprised. Okay, I guess we'll give it to him. Why not? I mean, he did pretty well in that fight, so I guess it makes sense that he should be rewarded at least a little bit. All right, so you can also upgrade your rackets, okay? So what you can do is... where is that now? Let me have a look here. I think I can go to... where is that actually now? I think it's here somewhere. Okay, so this is the diplomacy screen. So obviously you are wanted by the Chicago police, or at least I am right now with Mr. Capone, at least a little bit. And you have a number of different statistics here that you can see. There's the faction ranking. Our faction ranking is all the way down to the bottom because obviously we haven't really done too much. And then obviously you have your overview here. So that tells you basically what is the best possible thing that you can sell in your speakeasies, for example. And it also tells you what other people are doing in your neighborhood. And a variety of very, very useful information. As you can see, this is what we currently have. We have a brewery, and we have two speakeasies right here, and you have a number of upgrades here. Ah, here we go. There's the upgrade screen. That's exactly what I wanted to do. Okay, so this is not Capone's place, which is what we just took over. What you can do for a small sum, you can upgrade a variety of different things. So you can upgrade the security, the ambiance, the word of mouth, and all that stuff, and that all increases the prosperity of your particular business. So you're going to be able to gain more and more cash as time goes on. Unfortunately, these are quite expensive, so I won't probably be doing any of that, because what I'd like to do is save up my money and then potentially open another speakeasy in one of those additional derelict buildings. So we're just going to leave it the way it is. And you can see here that the draw at the moment at this place is not that good, so unfortunately we're not getting a lot of customers, unfortunately, but we're still getting a decent amount, I suppose, but hopefully it's just because we've just taken this over, and hopefully it's going to get a little bit better as time goes on. This is the finance screen right here, so you can see the overview of all of the things that are currently going on in your empire, and then you obviously have diplomacy, which is currently grayed out, because of course we haven't encountered any other gangs just yet. So, let's exit, shall we? Let's exit. There's nothing else for me to really do here.
Gotcha.
So let's go outside. And bear in mind that your leader actually does have to walk to all of these places. And you see this little ambush button down here? I can ambush pretty much any gang that I want to, as long as they are in the world itself. So if I, for example, walk around here, which is what I'm going to do, and then if I go literally straight in there... Actually, wait a minute. This is... up.
Don't fuck with me.
Oh, hello there. Okay, so we have met a new faction already. All right, so we have three options. We can threaten them, begin combat, or we can request a sit-down. A sit-down is basically opening up diplomatic relations with the guy, and then you have to speak to him, and you know, you can see what you want to do, whether you want to make peace, whether you want to make an alliance or anything like that. And, you know, for the sake of showing you those mechanics, I'm actually going to request a sit-down. Generally, what I would do if this was just my normal sort of playthrough of this game, I would probably just start attacking them almost immediately. Ah, okay, apparently the sit-down is over there. Okay, you know what? I'm actually thinking I might just go in and attack. Should I? Should I go in and attack? Actually, you know what? I'm going to go and I'm going to take this... I'm going to take this derelict building for the moment, because I would like to open another speakeasy if at all possible. I'm actually not going to attack it just yet, because I'd like to go to the vendor and potentially go into sell mode, because I'd like to sell this. Nope. Oh. Well, just sold his new weapon. Yes, I just sold his new weapon. That did not go well. That did not go well. Okay, well, yes, I did not mean to do that. I actually meant to sell his old weapon, but apparently I couldn't sell his old weapon because that is by default his, and I'm not allowed to sell it, apparently. So, unfortunate, but not entirely unexpected, I suppose. And we do have to fight against thugs. Thugs are really not going to be that difficult for us to deal with, so shouldn't be that bad. Anyway, I guess I'm just gonna do the whole, let me see here. Ooh, well, this is a bit problematic, isn't it? Not a big fan of this particular placement. Technically, what I could do is I could walk over here. Yeah, I kind of wanted to do Rain of Fire here. You know what? You know what? I'm just going to do it because that's going to suppress this guy, hopefully. Maybe at least hit him a little bit. Oh, yeah. Nice. All right, so that guy is pretty good. He's probably going to die soon. And then this fellow, we can probably do... Wow, 81%, and we have a 40% chance of critical. That sounds good to me. Let's do it. Ooh, nice. All right, that's very, very good. And now we can actually eliminate this guy. He's only got a... wait a minute. Let's change weapons. There we go. All right, yeah, there we go. That's much better. Let's kill him. Nice. Yeah, that's what I'm talking about. Very good. Okay, so we have that thug over there. He's going to attack from there? No, there's no way he's going to hit from there, of course. This guy's suppressed. He's dead. He had no idea what was going on. He was like, this guy's ripping into me like no one's business. Yeah, exactly. That's exactly what happens. Now, bear in mind that even though this ability is extremely powerful, you can see here it has a 6-turn cooldown. So, of course, it is pretty lengthy. Pretty lengthy. All right, so I'm going to move over here. And we do have Overwatch as well, by the way. So you can use Overwatch if you want to. And I think I might end up doing that. I'm actually not sure. Yeah, let's just do Overwatch because this guy might indeed try to move in. Oh, we're not in cover? Ah, interesting. So you can't do Overwatch while in cover. I've never done Overwatch before, so obviously that's kind of new to me. So that's interesting. All right. Well, that's not too bad. 77% chance might indeed end up killing this guy. Wow. This guy is an insane sharpshooter, is he not? Yes, absolutely. Okay, 36% chance. Not entirely sure if I really want to bet on the 36% chance. I might try to... I'm going to move over here. 55%. That's much better. Let's do it. Yeah, there we go. Taking him down. All right, so now we only have... Oh, he's actually moving? Oh, never mind. We missed. That was actually kind of funny. All right, so yeah, we're just going to hit this guy, I guess. 73% chance. We might not even hit. No, but thankfully, because Capone is using a handgun, he has 2 action points to spend if he doesn't move. Whereas if someone wants to shoot with a 2-handed weapon, like a rifle or something, it uses all of their action points. Ooh, I was really hoping that would hit. That would be a super, super nice thing to happen, but yeah, hopefully Willard will be able to murder him. Nope, apparently not. Oh, he's using a first aid kit. You imbecile. Why are you wasting resources like that? Alright. I'm actually going to move behind him right here. Capone's getting close. Capone is getting close. Okay, let's just shoot him right in the face. Okay, now, can we see him? No, we can't see him. All right, so I'm going to move over here, out into the middle of nowhere. I mean, this thug doesn't really have much that can really do anything to us. Oh, nice. Unfortunately, the guy has lived with 1 HP.
Fucking A.
1 HP. What are you doing? What are you doing, fellow? I don't know, but hopefully you're dying now. Yep, there we go. Nice. And there you go. All right, so we gained a shotgun. I'm going to be selling that, I think. We also gained a silk padded vest. Right, the bullet-stopping power of silk was originally utilized by European nobility in the 19th century. Now it's being used by Chicago gangsters as a lighter bulletproof vest that doesn't impair mobility or sacrifice effectiveness. Yeah, well, good to know. All right, so we'll just take the loot, and we will indeed take this over. And I will probably build another speakeasy. There we go. And shall we rename it something funny? Let me see now. Capone's Speak Tough. There we go. Because it's not speak easy, it's speak tough. There we are. All right, your rating with Ragan's Colt has decreased. Yes. You've picked up some body armor. Ah, yes. Oh, okay. So, yeah. I haven't gotten body armor before, so that's actually pretty cool. And can I equip it on Capone? Yes, I indeed can, and I think I will. Very nice indeed. Okay, that seems cool. I like it. Alright, so we're pretty good here, and I guess we can now exit. Let's do it. Let's exit. And we'll see, actually. I would like to go over and potentially speak to someone now. There is a sit-down. Time out in 20 days. Okay, so I'm actually expected at the sit-down, so I suppose I will head over there now, and we'll see what's going on. Because I do now have a positive passive income. We got a new talent. Do you want to learn about talent trees? I don't want to learn about talent trees. I've already done that. Oh, there are some enemies over here. Yeah, there are some thugs over there, which will maybe actually attack us, which would not be too good. But anyway, where's our talent tree? There's the talent tree. Okay, so here we go. Regardless of the amount of damage you take, you are now guaranteed to bleed out whenever your health reaches zero. Because obviously, people can die in this. You no longer trigger enemy Overwatch shots while moving. And any character within 4 meters of you will bleed out instead of dying whenever their HP reaches zero. So, it's more of a kind of medic trait. I'm going to be taking light-footed, I think. I think that sounds super, super good. So, we'll do that. And these guys are almost done with their talents as well. That's going to be a lot of fun. Alright, so let's just unpause, and we'll continue on to the... Ah, here we go. Oh, that's actually kind of cool. I would have liked to have done this. So you're coming up in Little Italy, are ya? Well, good for you, but you need to back off my turf, you hear me? Because I ain't gonna go easy on ya. Now, I'm a reasonable person, so I'm still willing to be friendly with you. Maybe I actually wouldn't have done that. I can't afford that right now. I actually can't afford it right now. Like, literally, honestly, I cannot afford it. I'm not sure whether I would have done that initially anyway. I feel like... Ooh, there's the cops. Wait a minute. Let's be a little bit careful here. Prosperity has changed in Little Italy. From mediocre to bustling, the locals have also changed their tastes and have started to prefer premium over top shelf. You might want to change what you're serving in the next month if you want to keep making top dollar. Check the Empire overview to change what you're serving. For the next month, both Top Shelf and Premium will provide a preference bonus in Little Italy. After the month ends, only Premium will apply the bonus. Okay, so Empire overview. So that's up here. Let's click on that, and then we can actually change what we are going to be selling. So let's have a look. Okay, so the preferred is this. Okay, so if we go over here, and then we change... Ah, so it seems like I have found where I need to be. So I actually needed to select the breweries rather than the speakeasies themselves, because the breweries are currently producing swill, which is obviously not particularly good. So if you've got the dough, you can upgrade those vectors now. If not, hey, it's not like it's going anywhere, right? Yeah, upgrading production will give you more booze, and who doesn't want that? And as far as alcohol quality goes, people will pay more for better quality. Alright, so you notice a few columns here. What you want to look now, see how you're producing swill? Breweries won't go making a new alcohol tape without your say-so. Okay, alright, so that is cool. So let's go through here, and then we can basically choose this. So we can basically go and we can change what we are going to be making. So let's do that. There we go. So there you go. As you can see, now it gives you a green tick mark, and it's basically cool, and then it will give you huge amounts more income, as you can see right there. So that's really, really nice, and I'm liking that a great deal. Okay, so we can also change what these are producing, hopefully. Can I actually change that? Alcohol quality. Okay. Here we go. Okay, so I can now produce alcohol quality. Okay, so I could upgrade it, but I don't have a huge amount of money right now. I mean, maybe we want to do that? Yeah, why not? Let's upgrade it. There we go. So it's going to take 25 days for us to be able to do that. I don't have enough money for basically anything else now, so I guess we'll just leave it alone for the moment, and we'll go to the sit-down. Hopefully we're not going to... hopefully we're not going to get killed by the cops. I hope not, at least. No, it seems not. And you can see here that there's a safe house here. Okay, so yeah, safe house is basically the HQ of the enemy's boss. And when you are ready, what you can do is you can go into those and you can basically be like, hey, I'm going to take over your territory or some other thing. Basically, what you do is if you can kill the boss, everything that they own is yours. That's pretty much how it works. So it's Very high risk, high reward kind of thing.
I'm glad you're willing to talk before things get out of hand.
Well, we'll see how we're feeling by the end of this.
We'll see how we're feeling by the end of this.
I'm sure I'll be feeling good whatever happens. You're making a lot of noise right now, but if you're gonna stay in Chicago, you'll pipe down one way or the other.
Let's just get to why I'm here, Frank.
All right. Straight to the point, then. I got a business proposition for you.
Go on.
I know the cost of running speaks in this town. I can show you the right corners to cut. Help you save some of those hard-earned dollars.
What's out of here? A free lunch? Get to the part where you ask me for something.
Word has it you got a good line on cheap renovations for a brewery. All I ask is you share that with me. What do you say? Have we got a deal?
All right, yeah, we got a deal.
That's what I like to hear, Al. You made the right choice on this.
We'll just have to see about that, Reagan. See you around.
Aha! Alright, so you've entered into a temporary business arrangement with Frank Reagan and will receive the following bonuses for 1 month. Brewery production rate has been increased by 2% and a speakeasy upkeep cost has been reduced by minus 3%. That's actually pretty good, no? I think that's pretty good. And our rating has been increased with them. Which is actually very cool. I like it. I like it. Okay. Oh, Willard has learned a new... oh, hilarious name. Okay. So, yes, I would like to choose a new one for him to learn. All right. So, bomb suit. Explosives deal 20% less damage to you, and the chance to be knocked back is reduced by 50%. You're now trained to equip and use rifles, or using explosive devices, your first action will no longer end your turn. That sounds like a good idea to me, so let's take that.
That's right.
And the other guy is almost done. It's going to take him another 2 days to learn that stuff. And there are cops running by, as you can see right there. You can actually ambush them if you want to, by the way, as well. I'm going to run away, because I don't want them looking at me too closely. Thank you very much. All right, so, yeah, now we can zoom out, and you can exactly see where the enemy gang is. So you can see he is colored in purple, and we are colored in blue. So technically what I could do is I would be able to take over that particular brothel over there if I wanted to, which might very well be something I'll end up doing, but we'll see. All attacks made against flanked or exposed characters gain an additional 20% critical hit chance. Killing a target grants you a free bonus move. Wow. Can only be triggered once per round. This effect is not triggered by abilities. I'm going to be taking that. That sounds like a super, super cool talent. And I'm very much looking forward to utilizing that as much as we possibly can. I'm actually just going to pause the game here. And I'm now going to end this episode off here. Yes, if you enjoyed the video, then please leave a like. If you would like to check out the game, there is a link in the description. And maybe you want to buy it. Who knows? Maybe you want to buy it. Anyway, I thank you very much for watching, and I'll see you next time.